ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. హరి ఓం, నమస్కారం. శ్రీమద్ భగవద్గీత సెకండ్ చాప్టర్ వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 13. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ దేహినోస్మిన్ యథా దేహే కౌమారం యవ్వనం జరా తథా దేహాంతర ప్రాప్తి ధీరస్తత్ర న ముహ్యతి. యాజ్ లార్డ్ కృష్ణ ఇస్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయినింగ్ అబౌట్ completely about the self of an individual. In the last words, Krishna explained this Atma means, which is in the form of I in every body, it is not disconnected with or by death and birth. That Atma, the Self, which exists continuously through birth and death and through death and birth. Therefore, this Atma, though Krishna doesn't use the word Atma, that has to be understood, this is Atma. Atma is eternal entity. Atma nitya vastu. Nitya means that which is eternal. So when I have to realize about myself, I have to realize that my consciousness, which is in the form of I, that which is experienced throughout day and night, it never has an absence, no absence. It means what? I am absent free person. That is the understanding which we should have in the beginning itself. Therefore, this last words, it says, you are free from death, free from birth. Though we are not that much matured to accept completely this knowledge, but as the indirect knowledge we should have. Pujya Swamiji uses indirect knowledge. Means as the knowledge, let it be inside. Atma is a nitya vastu. Nitya vastu means what? Trikale yat tishthati iti sat nitya vastu. That nityam means that which exists in the three tenses. No absence. It was there in the past, it is there at the present, and it will be there in the future too. Therefore, this Atma never dies. Okay, and there was no time it was not there. It means my existence, it exists all over. It is not limited by time. That is the understanding we should get from the last words. And we also analyzed these all four kinds of absence, because we also value, when we live, we survive, we value for absence in different occasion, in different way. If I have a car, I enjoy the presence of the car. If I have given the car to somebody else, now I enjoy the absence of car. I could feel I may miss the car. It means what? Absence of the car also does the matter. Therefore, my consciousness, which doesn't have absence at all, that is the proper first understanding which we get by that last verse. Now the second means the second understanding must be this: the self is free from all kinds of modifications. Modifications means what? In Sanskrit we call it vikara. Atma is nirvikari, vikara rahitah. That is the next point, that which we have to realize. Therefore, this Lord Krishna, he begins with dehinaha. Dehi means indweller of the body. Dehaha means shariram. Every Sanskrit name, it has got a kind of vyutpatti. Vyutpatti means a small definition, but that definition which is an appropriate definition. See, dehaha means what? Why this device is called dehaha? Because dahati iti dehaha, dahyate anena iti dehaha. That which keeps burning. See, the meaning of dehaha, that which keeps burning, and that which also burnt. You put something inside, a small groundnut, or small to big, anything you put inside, it will digest. That's what burning. It keeps digesting. See, that digestion is not only happening in the stomach part. So even, you know, this whole body is nothing but an accumulation, unity of the cells. Because we have to realize about the physical system, it has grown from one cell. It got one more cell from that first one cell. Then it multiplied so many cells, crores of cells, trillion of cells. All the cells, they are appearing as one sharira. Every cell has got a burning capacity, digesting capacity. Therefore, if some needle goes inside, some, you know, small, you know, this wooden piece, it goes inside. So all the part will work there. It will digest the foreign body. Either it will eliminate from the body or it will digest, you know. That's the nature of this body. Therefore it is called dehaha. And there is a consciousness with all the body. All this individual upadhi means shariras, they have one indweller. That indweller is in the form of I. That I is referred as dehinaha, dehi. Dehinaha means unto that indweller. There are some modifications which only belongs to body. He doesn't undergo the modification. Now, there are three kinds of states have been introduced by Acharya. But Vedanta introduces this Sharira which undergoes six kinds of modifications. What are they? They list Asti, Jayate, Vardhate, Viparinamate, Apakshiyate, Vinashyati. The first modification. The body was not having form, it was unmanifested form before entering into our mother's womb. Then it exists. Exist means what? That existence is nothing but a manifestation coming into name and form. That's the Vedantic language. Anything that, see, now you rub a matchbox with a stick, so you get the fire. So that fire, if I ask you where it was, now it is manifested, where it was. So it is there, it was there as unmanifested form. Okay, like we were also as in the unmanifested form. Then we manifested, that manifestation confirms the existence in the womb as a fetus or infant. That, you know, existent is known as asti, asti. This asti means what? Existence. That existence, it continues, you know, to be there up to the death. Then also it continues. After the death, it continues as unmanifested one. And the second one, jayate. We are, you know, coming out from our mother's womb. Jayate means it is born, birth. And Vedanta says only there are four kinds of births. It is says, andajam, jarayudam, udbijam, shvetajam. These entire creatures, you know, of universe, they only get manifested through these four ways. Either it should come through garbha, a womb, it should come out of the womb. We are born through the wombs. Trees have come into a manifestation being through seeds, udbijam, birds and etc. Like a cock, hen, etc. They come from the egg. Therefore what? Birth from egg. Udbijam, sorry, andajam. And if you dump, you know, this all dirt material, like you dump in a place, and that will get a kind of moisture, that heat. From there also, you get so many species, these small, small insects, worms, all this, they get, they, no garbha, no egg is there, no womb, and no seed also, but they are manifested. Therefore, this jayate is the second modifications for this physical system. Then the third one is vardhate. Whatever is born, it won't remain as it is. They keep growing. It grows. We also grow. That's the third modification. And the growth also in vertical aspects and horizontal aspects. Human being, we are, you know, like erupting means, it's like a vertical way of, you know, some people, you know, they also go side by side. But it's a vertical growth. And all the animals, horizontal growth. Animals, even birds and all. Now you see, when you define about this physical system, you have to define completely. So how many kinds of birds are there? Only four. How many kinds of growth is there? Only two, horizontal way and vertical way. Then, now you see, asti jayate vardhate piparadyamante. The growth also stops after certain period of time. Then what? We never kept growing. We stopped by 21, I think. After that, viparinamati, that some kind of modifications are taking place. The skin becomes thick, voice becomes thick. And if you are a male, you get a beard, mustache. And all these modifications are called fourth modifications. Then fifth, it starts decaying slowly after 40 or after 50, this all the skins, they lose their glow, and bones, they lose their strength, and blood also will become thin, and your eyesight, all these things, they will lose their complete potentiality, slowly decaying. Finally, you go into unmanifestation. Vinashyati iti. Therefore, asti means existing in the womb. Jayate means to be born. Vardhate means to grow. Viparinamate means to get all kinds of modifications which are necessary according to the age. And apakshiyate, decaying slowly. Vinashyati, going into unmanifestation. These six kinds of modifications, they take place in this physical system, explained in Vedanta. That same thing is explained by Krishna. He says there are three kinds of modifications. Kaumaram yavanam jara. Kaumara means boyhood. Yavanam means what? Youth. Jara means old age. He also says how these three kinds of stages are taking place to the Dehi. Dehi means to the indweller of the body who experiences all these modifications. And he should accept death is also a modifications. After death we won't be there to exist. No, we will be there with the other body. That Swamiji, in this place we are not able to accept. Keep going, because teaching is not completed. Are you able to see? Let us think in logical way. At 7 years old, you were self-conscious, because you know, human being, we take long time to stand. All these elephant, cows, all those animals, when they are born, they immediately stand and walk. But we toddle and we did all kinds of diving and everything. Then we started walking after a year or after 1.5 years. Then also we speak, it takes 2 more years. It means, so we could see when we were in childhood, if any furniture, if it would have been in your life, throughout the life, for example, some desk, some kind of almira, or some kind of, wall, short, in a small wall at the home. You might have, struggled to climb on. You might have struggled to take something from that table, almira. After growing, after 15 years, you could see that I was too short. I was not able to pick something from that almira. That difference is understood, realized by you. It means what? You never grow. You were there with the body and now you are with body, but you could see the difference between that sharira which was there 15 years ago, now the body after 15 years. Because you could measure by the help of almira, you have grown up. It means what? You have not grown up. Your body has grown up. You witnessed that growth. That's what is happening. When you were in the adulthood, you were so energetic. When you become old age, you could see you are less energy. You are endowed with less energy. Like when before sleep you experience you, in the sleep you lose you. After the sleep, when you wake up, you gain you, but you don't bother. But if In that case, means if it is, if you go to sleep, what kind of faith and hope you have that after sleep you will get up? Sorry to ask like this, even though, you know, we have to understand, we have the hope. Because we will be alive, the sleep cannot separate me. Though I lose myself, I will gain myself. Shastra says, in the same way, if you sleep in this body, if you disappear in this body while sleeping, and when you appear in this body, that duration is called sleep. When you sleep in this body, you be awakened in another body. This period of time is known as a death. It's a kind of modifications. You never lose you. You are away from all kinds of modifications. Therefore what? I am Nirvikari. Because even, you know, there is no size for the soul, this Atma. This mosquito has small consciousness. I have a huge consciousness. And all dinosaurs, they have, you know, very big consciousness. Elephant has got, you know, consciousness according to their physical appearance, physical entity, physical body. No, consciousness is beyond time and space, and beyond also with all these modifications. It means you are very clear, you can be very clear, I am not undergoing these modifications. If you are 25 years old, you need not to think that I am young adult, wow. If you have crossed 60 years, you need not to think I have become old, you have not become old. Your body has become old, but you have become matured enough to understand it. That is the understanding, second understanding. From the last words we got, that Atma which is in the form of I, experienced by me, is Nityam. It cannot be plucked from me. I never lose me. Even death doesn't have power to separate me from me. At the same time, I am also Nirvikari. I never undergo modification. It's not that I was born, I went under all the modifications, then finally I die. No, there is no death. There is no death for you. There is no modifications for you. It means what? They are a kind of reality. That reality only with the physical body. Okay, then this understanding, how will it help? How will it help in my life? Yes, when you begin something, when you interact something, when you enjoy something, you are having the understanding that I am limited. I am going to die. Now you are unlimited. You are not going to die. You are not going to undergo any modifications of your body. It means what? You are free from everything. That understanding itself, it brings lots of relax and rest to our psychological system. And this fact means this truth are truths. Whether you are able to understand or not, they are absolutely satyam. Then the benefit of this understanding is given in the same words. Tatra dhiraha na mukhyati. Now, this indweller of the body is not shaken, it's not fluctuated, he is not disturbed by the modifications of the body. Therefore, he never worries by the physical system. Because the reality of the physical system, it has the reality, it keeps changing. And you know, even this physical system doesn't have death. I tell you. And it's very easy to realize. If somebody is providing kidney to somebody else, he has provided, that transplantation have been done. Now, the giver of the kidney is, if he is passed away, that person who has been given, he may live for 50 years. A person who is about to die, his heart is transplanted to another person, that heart will function, it will keep functioning up to his life. Maybe because in future we may get a development in our technology wise, we may transplant heart continuously to 10 more people continuously. You get it done for one person, it can be replaced to another person after his life. We may have. It means what? These tissues, bones and all, they have no death. They are endowed with karma, action. If you place properly with other system, it will keep, you know, functioning. That is a clear understanding. You know, this is not enough even. Now Krishna, he is, you know, defining the connection between me and my system. First, he made us understand about that existence of our own self. Now he is explaining the connection with our physical body. And also he continues in the next words. Let us read. Matras parishastu kaunteya shitoshna sukha dukkhadaha agamapayino nityaha tanstitikshasva bharata. It's very minute analysis. Now the modifications, it never stops because that's beyond your control. Once you are born, you have to grow. Once you got that that purna means complete growth, then modification will take place. You cannot stop it. We may hide with all Godrej, hair dye and all natural dyeing. That body, it keeps, you know, its own progress. It won't stop for anybody. You may appear as a young, but body will grow to be an old. That's not in our hand. And you know, experiences through these modifications, through this body, how it is taken, how it impacts us. Because when this bride and groom are searched in India, they have their own norms. A girl thinks that a boy should be good looking, tall enough, and of course he is a good man, he should have a good quality in it. And boy also, he will also have his own expectations, that girl, she has to be like this and that. See, the life is dependent on this physical system completely. Wherever you are, so this physical system is given important. Therefore, this is a very important understanding about our own physical system. The connection between me and my physical system is very important. He referred the word matraha because this body is a sophisticated, luxurious place where I indwell. This body is an excellent product by Ishvara. Therefore, you know, this product means it is not manufactured by us. It's apavrusheyam. Therefore, we need not to afraid from this body, okay? This body is a sophisticated place. It is given to us that we have to understand properly. I will see you in the next episode tomorrow. Hari Om.